Welcome back to the final area of Dark Vision 9. Damn, they buff Odin really really hard. But we'll talk about that later. Let's start with the first stage in this area. The first stage is the physical domain of lightning and earth. Boss is beast type monster. There's not that much to say about this stage. It's not that hard. The only thing that you need to know is boss does wind and water damage. You need 100% after buff for those two elements. For real, boss has an AoE stop. If you do a 2 turn kill, you can ignore that skill. Alright, start with the first unit. Daughter of Destiny, Vanille. She here to do AoE Earth Imbue and 120% Earth Impel. That's all what she does. She's not gonna change, she's not gonna do anything more than that. So you don't need to equip anything on her as usual. Second unit is Fan. He will chain AR on kill turn, so you need to dual wield him with two weapons. And he's gonna do 85% break for us. Third unit is Mastermind Zorn, so he will be a physical evasion and provoke tank. But for real, we don't need that because all boss attack is elemental. So you have 100% resistance, you immune to all of those attacks. Marie will be an elemental buffer as usual. She's gonna use her cooldown to buff 100% all elemental resistance. And she's gonna do something special this time. So I give her dual wield to dual wield two weapons. Because I use Red 13 as a killer provider and I don't want to waste that damage. So I equip her with gusty attack. This skill has a startup rate chain frame. So we're gonna use this skill to chain with Red 13. If Tifa can cap alone by herself, you can ignore this. And another unit is Tifa. She will be a limit burst finisher. You need some limit fill gear on her normal form. And her breath form, just gear her for limit burst damage, beast killer and her attack. So with this build, she had 225% beast killer, 285% limit burst damage. The final unit is Red 13. He will be a killer provider and do a Stardust Ray Chain on kill turn. So build him with attack and beast killer. Alright, let's go. We're gonna do a 2 turn kill as usual. Let's start with Vanille. Use Overwhelm Magic on Tifa for boost her limit fill rate. Fan use Heal Limit Burst for 85% break. Maria use her cooldown for 100% elemental resistance. Red 13 use Heat Magnet Ability for 300% attack buff. Killer Lay for beat killer buff and whatever. Mastermind Zorn gonna copy that killer only. Because when you're on the second turn, she gonna use her cooldown to do team imbue. Dual cast is enough. Tifa shift to her brave form and use Awakened Fighting Spirit. Okay, on the kill turn. Start with Vanille, dual cast her cooldown. Defying Destiny and 100 arm. Fan and Zorn use their AR chaining move. Marie use gusty attack for her Stardust Ray chaining. Red 13 dual cast killer lift. And Tifa use her limit burst. Send AR first, followed by Stardust Ray, and finish with Tifa. Okay, 2.14 by Tifa. You don't need gusty attack on Marie. That's too much. Tifa alone able to cap this monster. Alright, move to the second stage. Alright, for the second stage in this area. This is a magical domain of fire and light. Boss is aquatic type monster. So same as usual, we're gonna use Terra to finish this stage. The only thing that you need to know here is Boss attack you with ice and dark element. So you need 100% resist after buff on ice and dark. Boss also has a non-elemental magic attack. But if you don't do a 4 or 5 turn kill, you can ignore this. Alright, let's start with the first unit. Mastermathon will be a physical evasion and provoke tank. As usual, we don't need that because Boss don't have non-elemental physical attack. And remember that he need to equip elemental weapon, so I give him Nick Stacker for fire element. Fan will be a breaker and do 130% fire imperial. He also need to dual wield fire weapon. That all what he need. Marie gonna be a elemental buffer. And as usual, we don't need to equip anything on her. And for Terra, we need maybe half gear here. Because I already tied with Terra Sword and Black Rosalia. She does allow 2 billion damage. Which means you need to add 1 or 2 equipment to her to do a cap damage. Okay, she has a 300% evil magic, 170% expert damage, and 110 limit burst damage. Okay, let's go. Alright, start with Master Marathon. He gonna triple cast his attack. Juan use his limit burst. Marie used her cooldown for 100% elemental resistance buff. And Terra shift to her brave form. 2 Magitek power release fire and trance burst. Okay, on the kill turn, Marie gonna guard here. Thorn and Juan dual cast AR chaining move. And Terra use her limit burst. Send Terra first. After that 3 seconds, send AR chainer. Okay, move to Dark Golem. Alright, for the final stage in this area, Dark Golem. There are a lot of things to talk here. Let's start with Golem. First, Golem is a stone type monster. He also has 60% all elemental resistance. You can use any element that you want, it's all the same. Second, he attacks you with light and water damage. So you need 100% after buff for light and water element. And in the end of turn 1, he also imperial your team with 80% light and water. So you need someone to dispel that or kill that imperial. There are 3 ways to do a team dispel. First, the unit already had that skill in their kit. For example, Benevolent Beauty Limb or Kyla. Second is, you'd use a dispel card. The method to insert Dispel Guard into your team is using Judgment Stuff, which is Warrior of Light Lena STMR and Dual Cast it. And the final one is use Bushido Freedom. The final method is quite dangerous because you can get team kill, but it can avoid by using one stack mirror. and my team use this method. I'm not gonna use Mirage because I don't have the room for that. So I decided to build my team with 100% evasion, except Edgar. And the final one is he has some random attack. The first one is a physical attack that has 95% accuracy and able to petrify your party member. It happens or not, it depends on your luck. The second attack is a water magic damage that able to inflict confuse to your party member. For this skill, it's a single target magic attack. And I think it ignores provoke because it happened to me once when he attacked my Terra and she gets confused. Alright, let's start with the team. With this team, as I said, I build all members except Edgar for 100% evasion. And this team needs 30% or more for light and water resistance on normal form and brave form. Not only that, Master Ison has to stand on Leviathan for Bar Wataga, and one needs to stand on Alexander for Divine Castle Protection. These two are the fixed Esper units. Okay, let's start with the first one, Master Ison. He will be a physical evasion and provoke tank. Yes, this time we need that, because Golem has a lot of single target attack. We don't want that to happen on Edgar, so we need provoke tank. Another thing that I forgot to mention, we need all damage that we can, so all units need to build their attack. We're not gonna left empty slot for now. So now we'll be a limit burst chainer, and hit gear in normal form, just build him for physical evasion, and I give him Craftsman Secret Book. He's gonna do a fire imbue for us on turn 2. And the rest of his gear just for limit fill. His breath form will be a limit burst chainer, so gear him with limit burst damage and stone killer. He has 300% stone killer and limit burst damage boost. Eileen will be a killer provider, limit gauge filler and limit burst finisher. Her normal form built for physical evasion, and I give her Bushido Freedom for a team dispel. She also has 100% physical evasion here. On her brave form, gear her for limit burst damage, stone killer and her attack. And I said we need every single damage. She had 200% stone killer and 230% limit burst damage. Vaan gonna be a breaker and AR chainer with Master Myson. Nothing fancy here, just gear him for attack and physical evasion. Edgar will be a finisher and he does some damage. And in his normal form, I give him Brumon Core. This is Kuja STMR. It has a 10% fire attack buff. If you don't have this, you can use Rain Neovision STMR. It also gives you, I'm not sure, 10 or 15% fire attack buff. It's an extra damage. As I said, we need every single damage. The rest of his gear is focused on limit fill. So he needs to use his limit burst on turn 1. On his breath form, focus on stone killer and jump damage. And don't forget that you also need 30% elemental resistance. With this build, he had 250% stone killer, 750% jump damage boost. Terra will be another limit burst finisher. Her normal form gear for 100% physical evasion. She gonna use Maduin Field or her limit burst on turn 2. And she bursts down enemy on turn 4. That's her rotation. Her breath form gear for Esper damage, Evo Magic, and limit burst damage. With this build, she has 220% Esper damage, 300% Evo Magic, 210 limit burst damage. And don't forget 30% elemental resistance. Alright, let's go. As usual, I'm gonna explain step by step here. start with Eileen, use her grand disability soul reactor to fill limit gauge. Sora, use any attack to generate limit crystal. Don't worry, we need to dispel. Buff Sora right now is useless. Okay, perfect. Mastermind use Power Water Gun. Juan use Divine Castle Protection. Edgar shift to his Breath Form and use Limit Burst. This Limit Burst increase his jump damage and decrease spear resistance for 25%. And Terra had a free turn here, so let's guard her. Okay, on turn 2, before doing anything, jump Edgar first. After that, use Bushido Freedom from Eileen to do Team Dispel. Because of 100% physical evasion build, we can ignore all of those damage. If you don't build evasion, Eileen will do Team Kill here. Sora use Furnace Flame to do Fire Imbue to himself. And Hera use Limit Burst to activate Maduin Field. Mastermind Thorn and Vaughn repeat their spell with Elemental Resistance buff. Okay, we move into the setup turn. Start with Vaughn, use Hit Limit Burst for 85% break. Eileen shift to her Bear Form and Triple Cast, Custom Drill for Attack Buff, Solid Breaker for Killer Buff, and Mantle Diver for Limit Burst Damage Boost. Terra shift to her Bear Form and Triple Cast, 2 Magitek Power Release Fires and Transburst. Sora shift to his Bear Form. Because we're gonna steal 300% attack buff from Eileen, I'm not gonna use his cooldown here. And we're gonna use Radiant Brand, Ultimate Finish, and Infinity Wheel. Mastermind gonna copy that, so critical on Eileen, elemental on Sora, and project to everyone. Okay, for the kill turn here, Mastermind Thorn and Vaughn dual cast their AR chaining move. Sora, Eileen, and Terra use their limit burst. Start with Terra. After that 3 seconds, send Sora, followed by AR and Eileen. Wait for 60 chain and drop Edgar. Okay, that requires a lot of work here. Damn, this is very very expensive team and very very hard. You need a lot of equipment and new unit here. I think that they buff Golem more than 30%. It should be around 40-50%. Edgar and Terra damage is very very high, but you also need both of them to cap this stage. That's all for this Dark Vision. Thanks for watching and bye.